Happy Easter from Angry Sturgeon Lures. So Friday I had big plans to make a lure from scratch out of some walnut, take it out, catch big fish, make a nice video for you. It didn't work. It didn't work at all. But while we were out doing that, walking around with a GoPro on our chest, looking like a professional videographer, I stumbled across a piece of driftwood, and we're going to cut that piece of driftwood open today and hopefully make some lures out of it. And it looks pretty interesting. So I hope to make more content over this summer of the lures actually being used. It's never been really my forte, but I think I can hopefully get used to doing it and maybe catch some fish, show you the lures in action. Also, if you happen to be in Southern Indiana at the end of April, I'm going to be at the Corydon Extravaganza show. I should have a bunch of lures, some original artwork, stop by and talk about fishing. And, what do you think? You think we should cut this? Let's go cut this driftwood. Yeah, we're going to go cut this driftwood up and, make some lures out of it. Struck me as odd. It looks like it's been cut a long time ago. The little aquatic critters have had their way with it. I have no idea what it is. It's heavy. It's dense. It's been submerged for a long time. Probably not going to get anything out of the middle of it, but I'm curious to see if I can salvage anything in this area here. So I put the big greenwood resaw blade on the bandsaw, and we're going to chop her up. Look at that. Look at that craziness. It's like cutting an agate. Let's see if I can get enough of that out of, make a couple lures out of. That's crazy. Not sure exactly how I want to go about this. I'm afraid if I, usually I can cut a block to get 3/4-inch slabs out to make a lure out of. And I like to kind of keep them as one piece, but because the pith, the branch goes through this burl diagonally, I might end up having to 1/4-inch slab the whole thing and then piece them together to make the lures. I just don't think I'm going to capture that crazy grain in a thick enough piece with that going in there diagonally like that. So it's still going to be incredible, but it isn't going to end up being a single lure out of a single block kind of situation. I think it's going to end up being slabs. I call them slabs. They're 1/4-inch, but we're going to call them slabs. 1/4-inch panels that I can make the lure out of. That is something else. there we go. It's full of sand. My saw hates me. But I think it's going to make some pretty good looking lures. It's going to have to dry out. No surprise, it's driftwood after all. So it's been completely changed into something else. Driftwood is a whole different ball game. Looks like we got definitely got some good stuff to work with here. Kind of like a little mini sawmill channel going here. There's no difference between this and what a sawmill does, other than scale. And that's why I bought the resaw bandsaw, because I can my media is not making furniture here. I'm making little 3-inch lures, so I can source from all kinds of small trees, even roots, shrubs, anything, and saw it up just like the big boys.
Well, it turned out to be a sinker, which isn't surprising. Driftwood is tough to get to float. It's just too waterlogged, and it turned out really dark, but it is pretty. I might get one more lure out of that piece of wood. I don't know. It's pretty brittle. Pretty punky. But fun project.